concerns the people of Ibadan Southeast local
Please.
Government, Ibadan Northeast local government, Ibadan Oyo State. My emotions are the need to make adequate plan and prepare for a post-oil economy in Nigeria. I also note that as a result of technological development and breakthrough, many advanced countries of the world have indicated their intention to phase out the production of the vehicle power by petrol and diesel and replacement them with a one power by renewable energy at various times before 2040. Also note that the government of France, United Kingdom, and the Holland have stated their plan to ban the sale of diesel and petrol vehicles between 2025 and 2040 in a push to clean up pollution city. Further note, some companies have started the production of electric cars and non-rigid solar panels to provide the electricity in a home and a replacement for noisy, unwinding gas bushing electricity plants. And for example of such company is Tesla in US, an American electric company, which produced about 80,000 electric cars in 2016, 100,000 electric cars in 2017, 86,555 electric cars in 2018, and produced 77,100 electric cars in first quarter of 2019. Aware that the implication of this is that no distant time, crude oil will have lost its global economic value and relevancy. Also aware that on 27 April 2020, British Oil and Gas Plant, BP, declared a quarterly loss of $4.4 billion as against the profit of $2.6 billion made in the first quarter of 2019, which is a testament to the fact that the oil and gas sector is already in crisis. Further aware that as a result of the deadly COVID-19 pandemic, even in the world now, goods are now selling for as low as $18.94 per barrel. Nigeria has so much good oil, but no country is willing to buy at this high price and do not have adequate storage facility in the country. Concern that this development is bound to adversely affect the nation's economy if adequate plans are not made in the preparation for a post-oil economy, as more than 80% of our foreign exchange income is realized from the sales of crude oil. Also concerned that the continuous depending on the crude oil is failing Nigeria as the era of oil is gone, and it will be disruptive if we continue to base our development project on the crude oil, and Nigeria is never going to become industrialized nation by selling more oil, even if the oil market is recovering. Recall that in 1957, agriculture formed 86% of our export revenue, but today the figure is less than 3%, as the country has gone from being a net export in agricultural products to a net importer of a food product. Concerning that Saudi Arabia, despite its massive oil reserve, is working on estimating the vision of 2030, which require it to diversify from the dependence on oil. Also concerned that United Arab Emirates, despite being a young nation, has managed to diversity, it is economy from almost complete reliance on oil in the 1970s to relation to a less than 72% of their GDP coming from non-oil sector of the economy, such as aviation, tourism, and the services sectors. Convinced that this present awake is blessing in disguise, as it should be compared to the government to take far-reach action, that we free nation from the entrapment of the crude oil. Also confused that Nigeria diversification should be embraced, agriculture as the primary sector and back for development, because agriculture is the key to ensure food security and sustainability. Further confused that with about 60% of its land access to arable, Nigeria is capable of becoming the food basket to the rest of the Africa. And in the process, it can capture substantial portion of the $48 billion that go toward the food import in Africa every year. Again, confused that when the huge opportunity of agriculture are combined with the invigorated manufacturer, micro, small and medium enterprises sector, then a new era of property, prosperity and sustainability will break for our nation. Resolve to number one, urge the federal government to direct its energy, resources and focus on how to diversity of economy from dependence on oil to affect the looming importation. Number two, also urge the federal government to liberalize the land tenure system to make it possible and easy for some of the 27 million unemployed Nigerians to have access to land to engage in farming. Number three, further urge federal government to set up a special committee to deliberate on the post-oil economy in Nigeria and make appropriate recommendations that will guarantee for survival of this nation's economy. Number four, and the last one, mandate the Committee on Petroleum Resources and Downstream, Upstream, and National Planning and Economic Development to ensure and compliance. Mr. Speaker, honorable colleagues, I so move.
Those in support of the motion as amended, please say aye. Those against, say nay. Ayes have it.